right, let's stand with our feet facing the same direction. Weight over top, distributed equally, and just bending nice and easy, keeping our heels flat on the floor, stretching out our calves. That's right, look out over your toe. Nice, easy stretches. Hands on your waist, but arms relaxed. Just work on increasing the circulation. Nice bends. And let's count down to incorporate some arm movements now. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Reaching forward. Nice, easy reaches. Above shoulder height if you like, or just simply at shoulder height. Whatever is most comfortable for you. You should feel the circulation beginning to flow throughout your body. It's increasing, your heart rate's increasing a bit. Ever so slightly, and then we'll do some leg stretching. And 5, let's change to the other side. 4, 3, 2, 1. Come back up, both toes facing the same direction again. Find your balance, hands on your waist, sun up and down. There we go. Look out over your toes. Nice, easy stretches. Nice, easy bends. Down and up. Down and up. The reason we do that is because you should have the circulation increased before you do any form of stretching, just so that there's a lot of blood in the muscle sites, so it makes stretching a lot easier. Let's count down to incorporate our movements. 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Reaching nice, easy reaches with our fingertips and arms. Work them up if you like, or simply keep them at shoulder height. Choice is yours. Today is our ore day. Lots of things for you to choose from. People who are confined to seated, then all you have to do is use your arm movements. Just reach nice. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands on your waist and turn. Walk your feet out. And walk your feet back in. This is warming up our ankles. We're going to be moving into our cardiovascular section, walking back out, and then we'll be branching off during that section to the beginner and intermediate level, so you do one or the other. And after that, we'll be doing our SOS section, which stands for soft odd spots. And today we're going to concentrate on the back and pectoral area, so the back and chest area. Walk them in. Walk them in, get a nice twist in your ankles. There you go. And now that they're together, let's bend to the right with our hands on our waists. And to the left. And once more to the right. Just nice, easy stretches. And to the right. Okay, are you ready? Start by marching lightly on the spot. Now I'm going to give you a lot of information here. Make sure that you are rolling to your heel when you're marching. It's very, very important, especially for intermediate people, that during this up-and-coming cardiovascular section, that you're rolling to your heel. You're not staying on the ball of your foot. That's very important, that you roll to your heel. Roll and roll and roll and roll. There you go. Let's bring our knees up. There we go. Reason we really concentrate on our feet is because you can develop shin problems if you're not very careful. And you should be wearing footwear, a nice soft sole to land on, and a nice soft padded carpet area to land on as well. All the padding you can give yourself is better for your legs in the long run. And now let's work on our back. Let's keep our backs flat, and by that I mean that you're not arching and nor are you slouching. Your back is comfortably flat. Your shoulders are back, and yet they're up, so that you're getting a lot of oxygen in through your lung area. You're not slouching down. If you're slouching like so, you're liable to get cramps. So keep your posture good. Now, I know I've just been spilling off of the mouth, but your form is very important during the cardiovascular section. Now, are you ready to branch off? You're rolling to your heels. Your back is flat. Your shoulders are up and back, and they're relaxed. Let's count down, and then we'll branch off to beginner and intermediate. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Beginners following me in the corner of the screen. Intermediate people here with me in the center. Beginners are simply doing a variation of the march. That's right. they're doing an on-the-spot jog. However, they're not bouncing like we are. Although, when we're landing on the balls of our feet. That's very true, but we're rolling to our heels. Concentrate. And we're just working on getting our legs warmed up a little bit more. Gradually is the way we do things here. There you go. And getting your toes out. Hands on your waist and they're relaxed. Nice, easy jogs. There you go. Bringing your toes forward. Come on. There you go. By now you should feel that your heart rate is increasing somewhat. You may be breathing a little bit heavier. Now your heart rate is going to increase more and more. Okay, now it's very important that you count down with me for a very obvious reason. If you can't count down with me because you're gasping for breaths, then you're breathing far too hard because you're exercising far too hard. So slow down the exercise. Perhaps do the beginner level. Or leave out the arm movements, because when we incorporate arm movements, we're increasing the heart rate. So try leaving out the arm movements. And if you're still gasping when we count down, move down to the beginner level, please. Don't overdo it. I appreciate your effort, but please don't overdo it. Be very detrimental. Let's count down to change this exercise. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, and 1. Kick our bottoms. Bring your hands back. Let your hands touch your heels. There you go. Good. Beginners are doing a variation. They're stepping back, bringing their heels up too. Now, it doesn't matter if you can't touch your hands to your heels. That's fine. Some people are more flexible than others. Some are lighter than others. Some are in better shape than others. That's why we've got all the different levels from which you can choose. There you go. Good. Bring them up. Good. Bring them right up. Super. Come on. You've got it now. There you go. Good. Touch. Let's count down to incorporate some arm movements. We're going to increase our heart rates, remember. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. And let's curl with our arms. Keeping our elbows in close by our sides. Starting off with a moderate arm exercise. We're working our biceps, the front of our arms, on the way up. And as we push back, we're turning our palms back, working our triceps, backs of our arms. So you're curling up and pushing back. There you go. Keep the heels coming up. It's very important that you don't forget about your legs. You concentrate. Exercising does take a lot of concentration. Don't let anyone fool you. Gotta think about what you're doing. Just think about it for a minute. We're rolling from the balls of our feet to our heels. We're keeping our backs flat. We're keeping our shoulders up and back and yet relaxed. Bringing our heels up to our bottoms or as high as we can. And we're curling our arms, keeping our elbows in at our sides. It's a lot to think about. So it's not gonna come overnight. It's gonna take a while. Just work hard, work at your own level. Nice, easy kicks. Let's count. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands on your waist and kicking out. Nice, easy kicks. Kick, kick. Concentrate, landing on the balls of your feet and rolling to your heel. There you go. No problem. Keeping our backs flat, hands on the waist, relaxed. Nice, easy kicks. Beginners are doing the same thing, although they're not bouncing. They're stepping, kick, step, kick, step, kick, step, kick. There you go. Nice, easy kicks. Come on, you can do it. Just do what you can. Control your breathing. Deep breaths. Keep going. We've got a tune coming up that picks up the pace quite a bit. So we're going to have to pick up our pace and work hard for the last 2 minutes. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Side to side. There you go. What we're doing is we're crossing our right leg over our left and our left over our right. Rolling to our heels, though. There we go. Nice crossovers. Working our inner and outer thigh region, as well as the fronts of our legs, our quadriceps, because we're bringing our knees up, up as we cross over. Hands in your waists. Good. Let's count down to incorporate some arm movements. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and reach with our arms. There we go. Now, please don't worry if your arms aren't moving at the same time as mine. There's no problem. Do whatever feels natural for you. There we go. The main thing is that you're moving. Keep moving. If you find that you get really tired, please don't ever just stop. It's a shock to your body. Even if it's just standing on the spot, doing the bends that we were doing during the warm-up, that's better than absolutely dead stop. Keep going. Let's work on some height. Come on. Side to side, bring those toes up and across. Rolling to our heels. There we go. Reach, reach. We've got less than 30 seconds left and then we're going to take our pulse rates. So let's work hard. Come on. Come on, you're almost there. Push yourselves. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Keep moving and let's take our pulse rates. Keep moving by bending your knees. That's right. Locate your pulse rate either on your wrist using your first two fingers or in your neck. Find it. We're going to take a 10-second pulse count starting now. Okay, now stop. Remember that number. Keep your legs moving. The number you've just counted, find it along the side. Find your age along the bottom. Where the two meet in the graph should hopefully be somewhere within this blue area. This is just to give you a general idea as to the range that you should be working within. If you're a beginner, of course, you will be lower than these numbers. That's fine. You're going to work your way up. This gives you an idea as to how hard you're working today, so you can improve to work higher, higher and higher each day. We're off to a commercial break, but please come back because we're going to concentrate on the chest and back area. And keep moving, very important. Today's SOS section is going to concentrate on the chest and the back area. And let's start with the back area. Pretend that you are rowing, that you have two oars in your arms. And reaching out at shoulder height, let's just push out and in, just like we're rowing. There we go. And push and pull, push and pull. Beginners are doing a variation. They're following us in the corner of the screen, working at their own level. They're taking rests, and we're maintaining our pace here. We're just pushing and pulling. As though we're rowing, this is great for the upper back region. It's called the lats. It's a nickname. There you go. Push and pull. Pull, really pull, sitting up nice and tall. Concentrate on that posture still. Form is very important throughout the program. There you go, reach and pull. Let's count down. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Arms down. Now leaning a little bit forward, let's work our lower back area. Reach for our toes and back. Toes and back. Bring your elbows right back. There you go. Good. Toes and back. Beginners, again, are doing the same exercise however they're taking rest. Keep reaching. Reaching. Now, the further you reach with your fingertips and with your arms, the harder you're working. And really concentrate on bringing your elbows back. So really tighten up that back area there. Good. And reach, 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 keep going. Nice reaches. Relax throughout your shoulder area, keeping your head forward, keeping your chin down a little bit. Get any tension through your shoulders. Careful. Let's count down 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Come back. Now let's concentrate on the chest area. Let's sit and bring our arms up and forward and back. And forward and back. And forward and back. Really concentrate on pushing them back. This is a nice stretch for the pectoral muscles. Chest muscles. I can't guarantee you any increase in size, but I can guarantee you that we will tone up. It's funny, I tried on a shirt the other day that I used to wear in grade 8, which was quite a while ago, and it fit. I was so depressed. I thought that maybe I couldn't get the top buttons done up. I haven't changed at all. Keep going. Not even doing these exercises has helped me gain any size on my bust, but it has toned. And that's the important thing. And forward. And back. And forward. Let's count down. 10. 9. 8. Really push. 7. Come on, beginners. You too. 6. They're taking breaks, though. 5. 4. 3. 2. And 1. Push back, bring your arms forward. Now we're going to concentrate on working on offering some resistance. So what we're going to do is we're going to push back and press. Press and back, rest and press. Press and back and rest and press. Press. Create some resistance with those hands. Push, push. There you go. Push, back, push, push. Back, push, back, push. Beginners are staying back longer. Push. Really push when you come forward. You're not doing the exercises. You really push. Push those palms together. There you go. Back, push, and back, push, back, push. Let's count down. 5, push. 4, 3, 2, and 1. And now let's do some crosses. Over and pulling back. And pull back and cross and pull and cross and pull. Reach for your shoulder blades and pull. As though you're doing flies. That's right. There you go. Now if you were lying down flat, these would be known as flies if you were just bringing your hands up above your chest and having them meet there and then bring them down to sides. These are known as flies. These are seated flies. Crossing over and pulling back. Beginners are doing the same exercise, and again, they're just taking rest. There you go. Keep going. Really cross. 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now we're going to come up, all of us joining together. And during our commercial break, we're going to concentrate on doing push-ups. Men, do men's push-ups. Ladies, do ladies' push-ups. Position yourself like I am here, and down you go. Taking your nose to the mat. Do 20 or else. See you back. Let's start our cool down on our hands and knees. And let's just do some nice reaches through to the opposite side. So we're taking our right hand and arm and we're stretching it through our left side. A nice stretch. And coming up and stretching to the opposite side. It's very important that when you're stretching that you are actually stretching. You're trying to reach as far as you can with your fingertips. And come up. This is a nice stretch for the shoulder area and the arm area, which we've just been working. To the other side. It's not time to fall asleep. It's time to stretch. Cool down gradually. Slow your breathing down. Come on. Once more each side. And stretches. Stretch out those shoulders. Stretch out your back. And last time this side. Stretch. Okay, now coming up onto your hands. Push your seats back to your heels. Keep your hands where they are. And now try walking them out a little further. Just walk them out until you can feel a nice stretch through your shoulder area. Now let's drop our heads to the mat. And let's cross our fingers over top of our heads by locking them across one another. Cross them. A nice stretch. Hold it. And come back. Come back out, bring your head. Bring your head right up. Look up. Bring your hands down. Take your chin to your chest again. Bring your forehead down to the floor. And let's walk our fingertips across over our heads. Take your time, walk them across. Feel a nice stretch. Hold it. And walk them back. Okay, and slowly bring your head up. And walk your hands back to your body. And right back. Sit on your bottoms. And let's do a nice stretch. Let's grab our hands out in front. And let's push. And lean back with our chin on our chest. Just push back. There you go. Really stretch with our fingers. Stretch with our palms. And a nice stretch. There you go. Sitting up nice and tall. Join our hands again. And let's stretch back. Keep your chin on your chest. There you go. We're out of time for today. I'd like to thank you for joining me. And you can come back tomorrow, or the next day, or the next day. Or the next day, we'll be here exercising, and we hope to see you back real soon. Take care. Bye-bye.